In this video, we are going to learn 5 different ways of learning Office and becoming super efficient in whatever work we do. The concept is simple. Whatever you see on the screen, whether it's a menu option or a button, has a purpose, and it is there to give someone a benefit, and that someone could be you. There is nothing useless in any app. So here are the 5 methods. First category is discover. That means you have a need or a problem, and you will find the most efficient way of solving the problem. Explore means noticing things which otherwise you would have ignored. And don't worry about time. Trust me, not only do you have a lot of time, but as you become more efficient, you will have enormous amount of extra time which you can invest in your growth. So let's see the discover method in action. The first item is local need. I have a Word document here. When you right click, the menu which comes changes based on where you right clicked. I right click inside a table, is giving me many table related options. But if I had right clicked here, it would give me paragraph related options. If I had selected a column, then it will give me column related options. What does that mean? You go to the place where there is a need, select it if required, then right click. You will find all the things you can do in that situation. Just look at them, think of what you are trying to do, and you should find the answer. Here is another example. There's the main menu on top. If I right click there, it gives me options related to the menu itself. If I right click in the document, yes, it gives me document related options. And at the bottom, there is a status bar. And if I right click in the status bar, it shows me various settings I can activate or deactivate. So right click is the right way of learning in a contextual manner. The next one is what to do when the need is bigger. For example, I'm going to zoom out this. There's a 13 page document. I want to look at all the pages. So when I zoom out, notice what happens. It is becoming smaller, but it's still showing one page at a time. The space on the left and right side is getting wasted. I would like to see more pages in the available space. Now that's a bigger need. So now we have to look for the correct menu which will have that option. The menus don't change. File, home, insert, and so on. So now you have to think logically and apply common sense. Will this solution be in home? No, because all the editing commands are in home. I'm not editing. I'm not inserting. I'm not drawing. I'm not designing. I'm just looking. So no. Yes. In the view menu, again, views, immersive reader, page movement, show, zoom. Zoom is what we are trying to do. So now in this, there is an explicit option. When you zoom in and zoom out, will it restrict to one page or multiple pages? Zoom the document so that you can see multiple pages in the window, exactly what you wanted. So click on it. And now when you zoom out, now you can see multiple pages and get the overall picture. So bigger problem, find the correct menu on top and you will find the answer. Let's look at the same concept in Excel. There's a pivot table, a pivot table. I have year, card, and category in rows and columns, and amount in the value area. Now, suppose I wanted to remove one of them. I right click, local problem. Look at all the options saying remove card, which is the field. So remove card gets rid of the card. Local problem, found solution in the right click. Now the next problem is I want to remove all fields and get a blank pivot table. Now, of course, I can right click 3 times and say remove, but that's inefficient. So now this is a bigger problem. Solution has to be in one of the menus on the top. Pivot table has its own menus. It's either in analyze or design. Design is about look and feel. You're not bothered. So analyze. Now look at all the options. Actions, clear. That's what we are trying to do. Clear all, and in one click, we cleared the pivot table. The third way of finding the right solution is to think, is my need applicable to the behavior of the application? And is it going to affect all the files? For example, whenever I create a new Excel file, 3 sheets get created. Very often, I only end up using sheet 1, but later on I'm going to forget whether sheet 2 and 3 have something or not. So it just creates confusion. Why not change the behavior of Excel and tell Excel, whenever I create a file, just give me 1 sheet. If needed, I will add more. How do you do that? Go to File, go to Options, and under Options, now look at the correct category. In this case, it's in General. By default, it is 3 sheets. I change it to 1. And next time onwards, when I create a new Excel file, it'll always have 1 sheet. Like that, there are hundreds of things you can change at individual app level. While we are talking about the pivot table, by default, pivot table comes in the new form. Many of us like the classic mode of the pivot table. So I want to tell Excel, next time onwards, create pivot tables in classic mode. Now, pivot table is about data, so go to File Options, Data, then make changes to the default layout of pivot table. Yes, exactly what I want. The setting for classic mode is in the pivot table options. We know that. So go to the display tab and say classic pivot table layout. Now existing pivots will not be affected. But next time when I create a new pivot table, it should be appearing in classic mode. So there you have it. App behavior change means file options. Here is an example in Word. I'm going to copy something from this document and paste it in another document. As you can see, the styles here are different. Colors, fonts, and so on. So when I paste it, control, it'll match the destination formatting. I don't like that. I want it to keep the source formatting. Not just this time, but every time I copy paste across documents. So you can change it from here, set default paste. In fact, when you click on it, it opens the correct place. Word options, changing the behavior. Advanced tab, scroll down, and here is what we want to do. Pasting between documents with different style definitions. Keep the destination style as the default. I want to change the default to keep source formatting. And now, if I paste it again, it will keep the source formatting for all future documents. So behavior means file options. Now that we have covered the discover part, let's see the explore part. There are thousands of things lying in front of us, but we have been ignoring them, thinking they are useless to me. Now think they are extremely useful to me. Let me find out where to use it. And that's called exploration. The first thing to notice is cursor shape. This is a pointing cursor. I can select or unselect buttons. The moment I come down, it becomes typing cursor. If I take the cursor to the left of the document, it tilts on this side. Whenever cursor shape changes, that means its behavior has changed. So click on it and see what it does. In one click, you can select a line, or in double click, you can select a paragraph. Look at this one. This is typing cursor. This one is to change the width of the column, but most of us miss this one. This is one click to select the entire cell. Extremely useful. Another common problem in Excel. Suppose I want to make the age column bold. Most people in the world will click on the heading of the column, not the heading of the data column. And if I make it bold, I may be applying the bold formatting to lots of unwanted rows beyond the data. And that's one of the reasons our file size increases unnecessarily. And what has this to do with the cursor? Look at it carefully. Remember, this is a table. When I hover on the column heading, the cursor will change to a down arrow. Agreed. When I come down, it is a selection cursor, so it becomes a plus sign. But I'm going to continue to come down, it again becomes a down arrow. That means it's still the column context, but this time it is column in the table only. So now if I select it and make it bold, notice things which are beyond the table are not made bold. Bottom line, observe the cursor shape. Whenever the shape changes, usually the right-click menu also changes. Now let's talk about double buttons. The commonest one people have not noticed is new slide. Most of us click here. Yes, it creates a new slide, but this button has the upper part and lower part. Upper part does the default action and lower part gives you more options. And from here, you can choose the correct layout. And because most people don't know that, they just click on new slide. The default slide comes and then they have to change the layout. Inefficient. So notice and use the lower part of the button when you are trying to do non-default action. Here is another example. Crop is a dual button. This does the default standard crop. But this one allows you to crop to a different shape. And this is a cake. So I want it as a circle. Actually, it's a rectangle, so it's an ellipse. No problem. But now I can click on the upper part of crop and then press Ctrl key and drag. And now I can crop exactly the way I want it. Notice the double buttons. Now let's talk about dropdowns. In this picture format itself, notice how many dropdowns are there. For example, here it allows me to quickly improve the sharpness of the image. Under the crop dropdown, I can make sure a part of this image is cropped in such a way that it will fit the entire slide. Slide is horizontal, so 16:9 aspect ratio. Of course, the whole picture will not fit. It tells me this much area will fit. Of course, I don't want this part of the picture, so I can drag, in fact, shift and drag, and I want this part of the picture. Now the picture is still small, so select it, go to the corner, while pressing the Ctrl key, drag it. And that's how you fit pictures to slides. Let's talk about more or advanced buttons. Here is an example. I have a long document and certain parts of it are highlighted in yellow. Why did I highlight them? Because those are important parts of the document. So next time I'm revising the document, I only want to look at the highlighted portions. I can see this in the first page, but where is the next highlight? I will have to scroll. That's inefficient. So what do? I go to Find Replace, Control F. If you open this drop down, you still don't see highlight. So you go to Advanced Find. Now here is the problem. I can't type the word highlight here. So that's where I need more features, more flexibility. So click on the More button. This is a formatting. So click on the Format drop down. And now you will find highlight. Now find next. Cancel this dialog. Control page down is the shortcut. The next find across pages. So this is how you discovered something really useful by clicking on the More button. In fact, I have a very interesting series on Find Replace in Word. Have a look at it. Here is another way of understanding more options. I have selected the picture. Go to Picture Format. You will see Picture Styles. And again, there is a drop down. And these kind of things are called galleries. Yes, there are more options, but they have to be used in a particular way. You hover on each one of them, don't click. It tells you if you use this, how will it look? Now it is in your interest to eyeball all of them. Only then you'll be able to choose the right one in the right place. Eyeballing them needs to be done only once. Your brain builds a visual vocabulary, and then you'll be able to find the best one for a given picture. For example, here, a simple 3D effect might look very interesting. Whereas for this picture, this will be the best option. So build the vocabulary, then use the right feature in the right place. Very often we use SmartArt, but we don't realize that we end up using 5 or 6 common things. Whereas there are 145 things, so you need to spend 15 minutes of life to build that vocabulary. How do you do that? Click on each category, click on each one of them, just look at it here visually and read at least the first sentence. It tells you when to use it. For example, this one is used to show steps in a process where each step is increasing the completion up to 7 steps. Once you do that, you'll be able to use the right SmartArt in the right place. And this discussion will not be complete till we cover Excel. As you know, Excel has hundreds of functions. Most of us have not explored them, and it is absolutely necessary for you to find out exactly the functions you need. How do we do that? Go to Formulas, click on Insert Function. Like we did for SmartArt, go to one category at a time, highlight each one of them, read what is written here. If it is relevant, note it down, then come back to it, and then learn each function one by one. So I hope you have understood the 5 simple but extremely powerful methods of learning Office, or for that matter, any other feature-rich application. In fact, you should try it out, apply it to your day-to-day work, and then let me know how it benefited you. Please share this with as many people as you can, because everyone will benefit from this. That's it for now. Wish you a very efficient New Year.